And let's get started. Let's lay down in your shavasana. I have both my girls at home today, so yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen. There's that. We lay down in shavasana. On the back. Legs slightly apart, and the toes fall open to the sides. Hands by the sides of the body with the palms facing up. And we begin to breathe here. Natural diaphragmatic breaths into the stomach, through the nose. Any worries, concerns, anything that is going on in our lives right now that is kind of making us distracted, we leave it outside of this room, making space for our yoga practice today. Let's bring the feet together, raise the arms above the head, interlace the fingers and give yourself a nice stretch. And exhale, release, bend the knees, roll to the right side on your mat. Maybe take a moment here. And when you're ready, slowly come up to join me in a seated position. Legs are crossed, spine spread, hands on your knees or chin mudra. Close the eyes and continue breathing here. Natural breaths, no need to forcefully control the breath. Allow it to flow naturally. And observe the quality of your breath today. Maybe how it affects your mind, and in turn, how this reflects on your body. And this is different every day, and even during the same day, the quality of your breath may change to reflect anything that's going on in your life, which in turn can tense up your body. So it's always a good idea to observe the three variables to get a feeling of how you're doing at any given moment. Belly breath. Let's begin to deepen the breath into full yogic breaths. We're going to feel the stomach like a balloon. When the stomach is full, the lungs expand, the ribcage, the throat. And exhale slowly and with control from stomach, lungs, and throat. Keep breathing deeply. And as you continue to take deep, full yogic breaths, make it a point to keep the inhale and exhale about the same length. And you can try to elongate both ever so slightly every time. Breathe naturally into the stomach again. We will take two rounds of Kapalbhati. And let's get ready. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and begin. Take an easy breath in, hold the breath, and as you continue to hold the breath, maintaining the spine straight, relax the body, drop the shoulders. And slowly and with control, exhale all the air out. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and begin. Slowly and with control, exhale all the air out. Keep breathing naturally. If your eyes are closed, open your eyes. Let's raise the arms up above the head. Interlace the fingers. Push up at the ceiling. Shoulders away from the ears, spine straight. Continue breathing naturally. Release, interlace in front of your body, curl the back, push away, separating the shoulder blades, maybe if the lower back is stretched here, navel towards the spine. And release, spine straight, open the heart, interlace the hands behind the body. Make sure that you can breathe and lift the arms as much as you can. If you can't breathe, you went too far. If you're hunching forward, maybe you're also going too far. Maybe lower the arms a little bit. place the hands on the shoulders and bring the elbows to meet in front of the body. Up and back. Let's make big circles. Three more. Two. Big circles with the shoulder joint. Last one. And next time your elbows meet in front of your body, change the direction. We start going back, up, and front. It gets a little trickier. Keep making big circles. Last one. And release. Let's come on to all fours. Cat and cow. Hands underneath the shoulders and knees underneath the hips, the hip bones. Make sure the knees are not together, they are slightly apart. Fingers are also spread wide apart. Grab hands, press on the mat, find a neutral spine. So the belly, the navel pulls gently towards the spine. Find a neutral position. Gently press through the hands. And on the inhale, gently project the chest forward. Find movement in the shoulder blades. Squeeze them towards each other. Cow. Exhale, curl the back. Now the shoulder blades separate. Press through the hands. Cat. Inhale, at your own pace. Slow, mindful movements. Exhale, lifting the navel towards the spine. Nice. Gently push the hips forward and inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And last exhale. And come back to center. Adjust the knees if necessary. And let's lift the right leg back. The toes point down at the mat, so the hip is not open to the side. The toes point down. One straight line. Good job, everybody. If we are stable here, lift the left hand in front of you. So it's the opposite arm and leg. Left arm, right leg. Breathe. As we exhale, bring the left elbow and right knee to meet underneath your body. Maybe touch. And inhale, extend again. Exhale. Inhale. Three. Inhale. Four. Inhale, and five, inhale. Bend the right knee, reach for your right ankle with the left hand, catch the ankle. You can come on the left toes if necessary for balance, and begin to push away with that right foot, opening the heart. Nice, breathe. And release the leg and the arm. All fours for a moment here. And whenever we are ready, extend the left leg back this time. Toes point down. When we're stable, right arm in front of you, breathe here. Balance, balance. Nice. Exhale, elbow and knee meet underneath your body. Inhale. Two. Inhale. Three. Inhale. Four. Inhale. Five. Inhale and stay here. Bend the left knee, reach back with your right hand, grab the left ankle, maybe come on the right toes for balance, and push away through the left foot, allowing the right shoulder to open. And release down to all fours. Come to sit all the way down on your heels. Lower the forehead on the mat. Let's take a couple breaths in child pose, balasana. Looking at your hands, curl the toes, and on the inhale, lift the hips up towards the ceiling, elongate the spine, sink the chest between the shoulders, drop the head towards the mat, and maybe begin to bend the knees alternately. Yes, bicycling the legs, finding a stretch in the hamstrings, the calves, waking them up. Good morning, legs. Stop at center, bend the knees and bring the belly to touch your thighs. Still pushing back through the hips. Yes, nice. Now keep the belly close to the thighs. Keep the spine long and see if you can begin to straighten just the knees without anything else in your body moving. If it becomes too intense, you stop where you are, find your stretch and breathe there. Prioritize the length of the spine. Look at the hands. Let's walk towards them. And once we're at the top of the mat, gently roll all the way up to do a couple sun salutations. Feet are together or parallel to each other underneath the hips. Hands in prayer in front of the heart. Tuck the tailbone in, ribcage in. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Connect with the breath. And maybe find an intention for your practice today. You may choose to dedicate your practice to a person, to a thing, to an idea. You may make a resolution for something that you've been wanting to do for a while. It doesn't really matter. But if you feel so inclined, then find an intention for your practice and keep it with you until Shavasana. On your next inhale, reach up through the arms to the sky, arch slightly. Exhale, fold, keeping the spine straight as long as we can. Hands next to the feet. Right foot back, knee on the mat, look in front of you. Step back, plank, hold the breath. Exhale, knees, chest, forehead or chin down. Inhale, cobra, open the heart. Exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale, right foot forward between the hands. Exhale, left. Fold here. Inhale, up. Exhale, prayer. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, left. Hold, plank. Exhale. Inhale. around, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, right. Hold, plank. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, right. Exhale, left. Fold here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, left. Hold, plank. Exhale. Inhale, open the heart. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left. Exhale, right fold. Inhale. Exhale, prayer. Catch your breath. And we'll move into our asana practice. Inhale, arms up and arch. Exhale, fold. Inhale, right. Hold, plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, the right leg up. Exhale, right foot next to the right hand. Left knee on the mat. Lizard pose. Let's sink the hips forward as much as we can. So if you feel like you're running back a little bit, bring them forward. And you can choose to stay on your hands, or you can come down onto your forearms. Your choice. If you have cushions or things around you, you can also find an in-between where you're not all the way down to your forearms, but you're not on the arms, you're a little bit elevated there. It's your choice. Make sure the hips are still sinking. Make sure that you are still breathing. And if possible, you're also still smiling. You're on your forearms, come up on your hands, and we're gonna pass the right arm underneath the right leg. So something like this, and place the hand on the mat outside of the foot. Okay, so you kind of create a shelf with the arm and place the hand on the mat. See if this is possible. Very good. Now let's see if we can walk forward with that right foot. Yes, yes, keep walking. And lift it off the mat. Yes, the leg will be pressing onto the right arm. One more try. Yes, go to Karasang, it's lifting, I can see it. Go, Olga, breathe. Nice. And release. Good job. From where we are, we will step back into plank. Knees, chest, and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Downward facing dog. Inhale, the left leg up. Exhale, the left foot next to the left hand. Right knee on the mat. Find your lizard pose. Sink the hips forward. Stay on the hands or on the forearms. Your choice. always mindful of your body and of the breath. Your body will tell you when you're going too far. Coming onto our hands, let's take the left arm now underneath the left leg, create a shelf and place the hand on the mat or the floor outside of the leg. Once we're here, begin to walk, 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 and see what happens. See if the foot lifts off the mat. Yes, breathe. And release, let's step back into plank. Knees, chest, and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Downward facing dog. Take the right leg up. And exhale, step the right foot between the hands. Open the left toes to the long side of the mat. Coming up into warrior two. Front knee is 90 degrees bent. Knee on top of the ankle. Torso perpendicular to the floor. Beautiful. Nice angle, everybody. Breathe, relax the shoulders. And extend through the fingertips. Keep the back leg strong as well. Right elbow on the right thigh. Let's lift the left arm overhead. One straight line from your left foot to your left fingertips. Breathe. Both hands on the mat. Step back into plank. Knees, chest, and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Downward facing dog. Inhale, the left leg up. And exhale, the left foot between the hands. Warrior two on the other side. Coming up. Keep the back leg strong. Opening the hips. Look at your front hand. Breathe here. Left elbow on the left thigh, right arm overhead, side angle, breathe. Both hands on the mat, step back plank, knees, chest and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, the right leg up. Exhale, right foot between the hands. And we lower the left heel to the mat. The left toes are diagonally facing forward. They're not completely open to the side. Coming up, warrior one. So your pelvis is facing forward to the front of the mat. Keep the back leg strong. Look up at your hands. Hands in prayer. Inhale, extending the front leg, step forward to the top of the mat. Let's bend the right knee, and with the right hand, catch the right ankle from the inside. Left hand can come in front of your heart, or you can take Chin Mudra and extend the arm in front of you. As we exhale, begin to gently fold forward and push away through that right foot, Natarajasana, dancer pose. Look at something that doesn't move for balance. Give it a go, nice. Good job. If you fall, it's okay. We all fall, and that's how we find balance. And slowly coming up. Both feet are together, raise the arms up above your head. And exhale, fold forward. Step back, right foot. Plank. Knees, chest and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. And we'll go to the other side. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left foot between the hands. Lower the right heel, lifting up into warrior one. Inhale, straighten the front knee and step forward to the top of your mat. Transfer your body weight to the right foot. Bend the left knee. With the left hand, catch the left ankle from the inside. Look at something that doesn't move for your drishti. And as we exhale, extend into your dancer pose. Natarajasana. I don't have the best balance today. So if this is your case, be kind with yourself. It's okay. Breathe. And slowly release. Come back to standing. Raise the arms up above your head. Exhale, fold forward. Let's go back through the left foot now. Plank. Exhale, knees, chest and chin. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a couple breaths here. If you need to rest, you may take a child pose. If you are in child pose, come up into downward facing dog again. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, step the right foot between the hands. Open the left toes to the long side of the mat. And we'll bring the right hand to the inside of the right foot, right next to it. Just lower the hips a little bit so the right thigh is parallel to the floor. And we can lift the left arm up to the ceiling. See how that feels? If this is too much for you, you can always come with the right elbow on the right thigh. Now, if you want a challenge, you can take the right arm underneath the right leg, wrap it around your back, wrap the left and catch your hands behind your back. If you have the hands, look up at the ceiling here again. And look down at the right foot and step forward with the left until both feet are together. This is a challenge, this is for fun. It's okay if we fall. Transfer your body weight to the left foot and see if you can begin to lift your body up. Continue catching the right leg. Good job, Olga. Once you're standing, see if you can extend that leg. Nice. Good job. Good try, Chikara-san. And slowly release the leg. Release everything, come to standing. Let's go for the other side. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, right leg back. Step back, plank. Knees, chest and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Downward facing dog. Take the left leg up. As we exhale, step the left foot between the hands. Open the right toes to the long side of the mat. Left hand on the inside of the left foot. Open the right arm up to the ceiling. Let's breathe here first. And see if we can wrap the left arm around the back under the leg and right arm catch the hand. Look up at the ceiling here again. Look down at the left foot and step forward with the right. Once you have both feet together, transfer the body weight to the right and begin to lift up. Yes, nice. Once you're up, see if you can straighten the leg. Good job. And slowly and with control, let it go. Good job, nice. Both feet are together, raise the arms up. Exhale, fold. Right leg back, plank. Knees, chest and chin down. Inhale, cobra. Downward facing dog. Take a couple breaths. And bring the feet together. From here, lift the right leg up as high as we can. And bend the right knee, opening the hips. See if you can look up at the ceiling from underneath your right armpit. And you have two choices. You can stay here and that's enough, or you can drop the right foot behind you, push the hips up and arch. And slowly coming back. If you arched, bring the hands back to center. Leg stays up. Move into a plank with the right leg still up. Three-legged plank. Yes. Balance on your left toes forward. Chaturanga. All the way down. And cobra. Downward facing. Make sure you have space on the other side. I'm really close to the wall on this side. Bring both feet together. And let's lift the left leg as much as we can. Bend the knee and open the hips. Look up at the ceiling from underneath the left armpit. We can stay here. This is enough. Or drop the left foot behind your body. Push the hips up. Push up from the hips and turn. Coming back to center, the head first, leg stays up, moving into plank, keeping the left leg up, balance forward on the right toes, chaturanga, one straight line, and cobra. Downward facing dog. Drop the knees on the mat. Bring the feet inside your body with the soles together and bring them as close as you can to yourself. Bring the feet as close as you can with the soles together. With the index and middle fingers, either catch the big toes or just use the hand to catch the whole front area of the foot. And let's flap here first. Open the heart. Yes, drop the shoulders away from the ears. Come to center, inhale, elongate the spine, push forward from the heart. Good job, nice posture, Olga. And exhale, fold forward, trying to get long, dropping the knees. Breathe. You can use the elbows to kind of push the calves down. If necessary, you can push with the elbows. Breathe. Inhale, come up. Extend the legs in front of you, Paschimottanasana. Forward fold. Make sure you're sitting properly, your spine is straight. Raise the arms up, inhale and elongate. And exhale, fold forward onto the legs. Welcome back, John. Catch the feet or the legs. Wherever you are, drop the shoulders away from the ears. Yes, opening from the chest, pulling forward. Good job. Chikarasan, look away in front of you. Yes. Now from the heart. Yes. So if you're not quite sure what that movement is to open the heart, it's kind of this. When we try to puff up the chest and push the shoulders back, almost as if you wanted to do this movement, using the feet as your resistance. So you grab the feet or the legs and kind of push through the heart. And you will feel it more in the legs. I can see it in your faces. Good job. And that means you're doing it good. It's a good thing. And we enjoy it. And we breathe into that. Yes. And slowly come up. We'll take a spinal twist. Take the right foot outside of the left knee. Left foot next to the right hip. Right hand behind your body, left one up, inhale, and twist to the right, either hug your leg or push it away with your arm. And release to center. Let's change sides. So the right foot next to the left hip now, and the left foot outside of the right knee. Left hand behind your back. Everybody okay? Yes, left hand behind the back, right one up. Inhale, elongate. Exhale, twist.
breath now, either hug the leg or use the arm to push it away or bind. You can also bring the left arm, right arm actually, inside the left leg and wrap the left one around your back and catch your hands if that's possible for you. And release. Now if headstand is in your practice, you may take a headstand. You may also take a shoulder stand. And whichever it is that you choose to take, let's take 10 breaths together in it. So either the headstand, you can also use the wall, or we take the shoulder stand and we try to take 10 breaths there. And once you've taken 10 breaths, we gently come out. If you're in the headstand or the shoulder stand, slowly begin to come down with control. And find your Shavasana. Slowly coming up and we meet in Shavasana. Now if you feel like you need an extra stretch anywhere in the body, feel free to give yourself that extra stretch and then find your Shavasana. Make sure that you are comfortable. Do any adjustments that you need. And once you're settled, begin to allow the body to fall in a deep, deep state of relaxation. We've moved a lot today, and you may notice that at times the breath turns a bit shallow, and that's okay. But if the breath is still shallow, or if you feel like you're still controlling it in any way, let go of that control and start to allow it to flow naturally again, just like we did at the beginning of the class. No tension anywhere in the body. Anchored on the breath. We focus on the present moment only.
slowly begin to bring awareness back inside the body. Wiggle your fingers and toes. Bring the feet together. Raise the arms above your head. Interlace the fingers and give yourself a nice stretch. And exhale, release. Roll to the right side on your mat. Whenever you're ready, come meet me in a seated position. Legs are crossed, spine straight, hands on your knees, Urdhva Mudra. And breathe here. We'll chant Om three times. Inhale. And slowly open your eyes. Thank you. I hope that you enjoyed.
If you did, please support my channel by giving this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to Practice Together Again, and I will see you in my next class.